So in this video, we will study about the various classification system for the pelvic fractures. So as mentioned here, we have the two classification system. We have the tile classification, we have the Young and the Burgess classification. This Young and the Burgess classification is the more commonly used. The basic fundament of these classification system is that it is based upon the stability of the pelvis, and more importantly, it is based upon the mechanism of injury to the pelvis. Now studying the basic anatomy of the pelvis, we have the two hip bones. We have the ilium, which has the ilium, ischium and the pubic component. Posteriorly, we have the sacrum, which articulate with the two hip bones with the formation of the sacroiliac joint. And anteriorly, we have the pubic symphysis. So this forms a ring-like structure. So any injury to the ring, if it involves one part of the ring, there will be injury to or chances of injury to the another part of the ring also. So we will treat a pelvic bone as a ring, and we will study accordingly. Now beginning with the first classification system, which is the tile classification. Now this classification system is based upon the stability of the pelvic ring. Now to begin with, it has three types. So we have the type 1, type A, in which pelvic ring is stable. Now it can be stable in two ways. Either it can be stable because the fractures are not involving the ring itself. So one is the fractures that are not involving the rings. So what all fracture can be? It can be avulsion fracture, it can be a like wing fracture. So these all fractures are not involving the ring itself. So these are classified as 1A fracture, in which pelvic ring is the stable. So these are the avulsion fractures and like crest fractures. Again in A2, these are the stable but they are minimally displaced fracture of the pelvic ring. So there is a fracture of the ring, but it is a stable and it is minimally displaced. So again the pelvic ring is stable. So type 1A is the pelvic ring stable fractures. In type B, now pelvic ring is stable vertically but it is unstable rotationally. So it is unstable in rotation. Like it can be a lateral compression injury or it can be anterior posterior injury. But vertically it is stable. But rotationally it is unstable. So we have the two types. We have the open book type. So open book types, in which the pelvis opens up. So pelvic will open up anteriorly at the pubic symphysis and posteriorly at the SI joint. So this is a type of the anterior posterior compression. When there will be an anterior posterior injury to the pelvis, it will open up. So type 1, B1 is the open book injuries, which is the anterior posterior compression type. B2, it is a lateral compression type injury, where the pelvis is the laterally compressed. So if there is a force directed laterally to the pelvis, so it will be a laterally compressed type of the B2 fracture. Now difference between B2 and B3 is that in B2 there is only ipsilateral lateral compression, while in B3 there is lateral compression along with the contralateral side injury. So in B2 it is ipsilateral injury, lateral compression injury only, while in B3 there is injury to the contralateral side also. So this was about the B2 type, which was unstable rotationally but it was stable vertically. Coming about to the B3 type, which is unstable both rotationally and vertically. So classifying it is into three types. It can be unilateral, involving the one half of the pelvis. It can be bilateral, involving the both half of the pelvis, or it can be types 3C3, in which it is associated with the acetabulum fracture. So this was about the tile classification. Now discussing it again. So in tile A, 1A, it was a like crest fracture in which the ring remains stable. In A2, there is a fracture of the ring, but it is stable and it is minimally displaced. B was the rotationally unstable and vertically stable. It can be an open book injury, injury to the anterior symphysic pubis ligaments, which can be unilateral or bilateral. In B2, so this was the type of the anterior posterior compression injury. In B2, it is a lateral compression injury. So it can be laterally compressed, either ipsilaterally, or it can cause injury to the contralateral side also. So there is a lateral compression injury here, and it is causing a contralateral injury also. So coming upon to the type C, it was a vertically unstable fractures. So here it can be unilateral, only one half is involved. It can be bilateral, both the halves are involved, they are vertically unstable, or it can be associated with the acetabulum fractures, which is C3. So this was about the tile classification. This classification is not that commonly used. And a more commonly used classification is the Young and the Burgess classification. So Young and Burgess classification classifies the pelvic fracture depending upon the type of the injury. So first is the lateral compression type injuries. So in lateral compression type injuries, we have three types. So this is the LC, lateral compression type 1. So in type 1 injury, so in lateral compression injury, as it is compressed laterally, there are more chances of injury to the rami. There are more chances of fractures of the rami, and there is less chance of the pubic diastasis. So anterior injury, we will be expecting a fracture of the rami, and as it is compressed laterally, there will be impaction fracture of the sacrum or SI joint disruption. Fracture dislocation of the SI joint. So in lateral compression type 1, it is anterior injury which is a rami, and plus there is a sacrum fracture which is an impaction type of the fracture. So this is about the LC1, in which anterior injury is the fracture of the rami and posterior injury is the impaction fracture of the sacrum. Coming upon to the type 2. So in type 2, there will be fracture dislocation of the SI joint. There will be anterior injury in the form of fracture of the rami, and there will be disruption of the or fracture dislocation of the SI joint. Now depending upon the how amount of the SI joint is involved on the axial section, it can be classified into three types. So we will look up on the axial sections, and we will classify how percentage of the SI joint is dislocated, and we will classify into three types: anterior one third, middle one third, and the posterior one third. In type 2, which is the lateral compression type of injury. Coming upon to the type 3, so it is a type of the windswept injury, in which on one side there will be lateral compression type 1 or type 2 injury, whereas on the contralateral side there will be a anterior posterior type of injury. So it will be a wind swept injury. So one side there will be fractures, rami fractures along with the impaction fracture of the sacrum or the SI joint fracture dislocation, and on the contralateral side there will be open book type of the injury. So this is about the lateral compression type of the Young and Burgess classification. So we will relook it. So in type 1, so as it is a lateral compression, there will be a pubic rami fracture and not a diastasis of the symphysis. So in type 1, it was a pubic rami fracture, which is an anterior injury, and posterior injury is the sacral impaction fracture. In type 2, lateral compression type 2, there is a transverse pubic rami fracture, anterior injury, and posteriorly there will be a iliac fracture, SI joint disruption, fracture dislocation. In lateral compression type 3, anteriorly again there will be pubic rami fracture, but on contralateral side there will be an open book injury, which is a anterior posterior type of injury. So this was about the lateral compression injury. Now coming upon to the second type, which is the anterior posterior compression or open book type of injury. anterior, we will, in this APC classification, we will move from anterior to posterior. In type 1, there will be only opening up of the anterior ligaments. In type 2, there will be disruption of the anterior ligament, plus in the SI joint, there will be disruption of the anterior part. And while the posterior SI ligaments will be intact. In type 3, there will be complete disruption of the anterior as well as the posterior ligament. So in type 1, it was disruption of the pubic symphysis, which is the pubic diastasis. In type 2, there is pubic diastasis, but anterior SI joint ligaments are disrupted, but the posterior ligaments are intact. While in type 3, there is complete disruption of the anterior as well as the posterior SI ligaments. So this is the open book injury, which is the anterior posterior compression injury. So revising it again, anterior posterior. Anteriorly, there will be a pubic diastasis, and posteriorly, there won't be any injury to the anterior and the posterior joint ligament. So there will be only stretching injury to the anterior and the posterior SI joint ligament, but injury will more be on the anterior pubic diastasis, symphyseal diastasis. In anterior posterior compression type 2, there will be a diastasis anteriorly, and posteriorly there will be disruption of the anterior SI joint ligament, while the posterior SI joint ligament will be intact. In type 3, there will be pubic diastasis anteriorly, and there will complete disruption of the anterior as well as the posterior SI joint ligaments in APC3. Now coming upon to the third type, which is a vertical shear type. A vertical shear type, there will be a gross displacement of one or both the pelvis, both the hemipelvis, superiorly or inferiorly. So this is a vertical shear type of the fracture. And lastly, we have the combined mechanism, in which any of the three combinations can coexist. So this was about the Young and the Burgess classification. So we will revise it again. So starting with the tile classification. So tile classification depends upon the stability of the ring. In type A, it was a stable, which can be a avulsion fracture or the iliac crest fracture. Type B, it was a rotationally unstable but vertically stable, and it was open book in the B1. In B2, it was lateral compression, and in B3, it was a bilateral injury. In type C, which was a vertical disruption, which was, the ring was rotationally as well as the vertically unstable. So it was unilateral in 1, in 2 it was bilateral, and in 3 it was associated with acetabulum fractures. And Young and Burgess classification, it was based on the mechanism of injury, lateral compression, anterior posterior compression or vertical shear. Lateral compression, in 1 it is Ramayi fracture and the sacrum impaction. 2, it was Ramayi fracture and the SI fracture, dislocation of the SI joint. In 2, it was the Ramayi fracture and the SI joint fracture dislocation. In 3, it was the contralateral open book type of injury. In anterior posterior compression, in type 1, it was the pubic diastasis. Type 2, it was pubic diastasis with the injury to the anterior SI joint ligament. Type 3, it was the complete disruption of the anterior as well as the posterior SI joint ligament. In vertical shear, it was a cranial or caudal displacement of one of the hemipelvis or both of the hemipelvis. So this was about the classification of the pelvic ring fractures. Thank you.